Amen. Truly, God is arousing and awakening an organic type of praise and worship. Look at this man of God. It's so great to see you here. Praise the Lord. And Elder Bailey said it so profoundly. He said, this is like a family reunion. And so with that being said, I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. Amen. How great is our God.
Sing with me, how great
is our God.
Oh, we'll sing. Oh, we'll see how great.
Oh, my, how great. Come on. He's our God. We can put our hands together if you know it. Sing it along. How great. How great is our God.
Is our God.
Sing it with me.
Sing with me.
How great.
How great is our God.
We all will sing.
Oh, we'll see how great.
All creation will sing.
How great.
All creation will see
is
he is great.
God.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Now, everybody, would you lift your voice? Sing it again. How great.
How great
is our God.
Is our God.
Sing with me.
Sing with me. How great
is our God. Is our God. All we'll see.
Oh, we'll see how great. How great is our God. How great is our God. Sing with me, how great is our God. Oh, we'll see how great is our God. How great is our God. Sing with me, how great is our God. Oh, we'll see how great is our God.
Here it is, you're the name that's above, come on.
You're the name.
It. Come on, sing it again. You're the name above every name.
You're the name above all names.
You are worthy.
You are worthy of all praise.
And my heart will sing.
And my heart will sing.
How great is our God.
Is our God.
How great
is our God.
Is our God.
Sing with me. Sing with me. How great
is our God.
Is our God.
Come on. All will sing. Come on.
All will see how great.
How great.
How great
is our God.
Is our God.
Hallelujah. Yes, one more time. Will you lift your voice? You're the name that's above every name. Come on.
You're the name above all names.
You are worthy to.
You are worthy to all praise.
Yes, you're worthy to be praised. And my heart.
And my heart will see.
How great.
How great is our God.
Yeah, we can put our hands together one more time. You're the name that's above all names. Come on, tell them.
You're the name above all names.
You are worthy of all praise. Come on.
You are worthy of all praise.
And my heart will sing.
And my heart will sing.
How
great
is our God.
Is our God.
How great,
hallelujah,
he is our God.
Sing with me, how great is our God.
Oh,
we'll see how great, how great is our God.
How many feel the joy of the Lord as we feel the atmosphere? One more time.
How great
is our God.
Is our
sing
God.
With me.
Our God.
Oh, we'll sing.
Oh, we'll see how great.
Hallelujah.
How great is our God.
To God be the glory for the greatness of our God that we happen to know as Father. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, people of God. Let's present in this atmosphere, prepare our hearts, amen, for the red word of the Lord. Praise the Lord. Come on, let's read the scripture as we charge this atmosphere with the word of the Lord. God bless you, team. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Might be unplugged, but God is in power still, is in the spirit. Amen. Amen. I'm going to read coming from this morning from 1 Corinthians chapter 11. We're going to start at verse 1 through 17. If you can, please stand with me. Happy Father's Day to all the fathers. That was a comedian making a joke about Father's Day. He said, of all the lists of the Father's Days, celebrations, Father's Day was wrote down on list number 40 or something like that. I'm like, wow, man, you got to be kidding me. But hey, it is. Maybe that means we just got a little bit more work to do. Amen? Okay. And it reads, be ye followers of me, even as I also am of Christ. Now I praise you, brethren, that you remember me in all things and keep the ordinance as I deliver them to you. But I would have you know that the head of every man is Christ, and the head of the woman is the man, and the head of Christ is God. Every man praying or prophesying, having his head covered, dishonoreth his head. But every woman that prayeth or prophesies with her head uncovered, dishonors her head. For that is even all one in as she is were shaven. I'm sorry, let me read that. For that is even all one as she were if she were shaven. For if a woman be not covered, let her also be shorn. But if it be a shame for a woman to be shorn or shaven, let her be covered. For the man indeed ought not to cover his head, for as much as he is the image and the glory of God, but the woman is the glory of the man. For the man is not of the woman, but the woman of the man. Neither was the man created for the woman, but the woman for the man. For this cause ought the woman to have power over her husband, over her head, of the angel, because of the angels. Nevertheless, neither is the man without the woman, neither the woman without the man in the Lord. Again, as I always say, don't just be readers of the word of God, be readers and doers. Amen? Amen. Amen.
There you go. One, two.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
One, two.
On this Father's Day, I want to give glory to the Father in heaven and pray the Lord's Prayer as Jesus taught the disciples to pray. You may pray with me if you like. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come. Thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debt as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen.
Amen. Yes. Father, we thank you for everything that you do for us. We take nothing for granted. For the blessings you send my way, I've got to say hallelujah. Lord, I want to say thank you. Here we go, team. Would you lift your voice? Tell them thank you.
Thank you for all you've done.
To say, come on. So good, and because even my poor decisions and our poor choices in life and our mistakes, they didn't disannul that contract that you made with us.
to nullify that covenant that you made with us. Father God, you are so faithful. And we're so grateful for the blessings you sent my way. Father, I gotta say, Lord, I wanna say thank you for the blessings you sent my way. Yeah. Lord, I gotta say, yes. Lord, I wanna say thank you with your voice and say
for the blessings you sent my way.
Lord, I gotta say,
I gotta.
And I would close in my right mind.
I've got a
using activities of my limbs.
I wanna say thank you.
It wasn't my alarm clock that woke me.
For the blessing you sent my
It wasn't my alarm clock that woke
I've
me.
Got a
but it was you, Jesus.
I wanna
You didn't have to give your life, but you did.
I wanna say yeah.
Brand new mercies with the rising of today, son.
For the blessing
brand new mercies. Brand new mercies. Brand new mercies. Yes. But I gotta say, yeah.
Say
thank you one more time for the blessing, for the blessing you
sent my way.
Lord, I've got to say,
I've got to say,
I
want to say thank
That's why I lift my voice and I say thank you, you
I just want you.
That's why I can stand in your sanctuary and give you glory.
I just
Thank you, Jesus. You're so good to us. You're so kind to us, Lord. Your mercies never run out, never run low, never run dry.
Just want to tell you,
Lord, I love
you. Lord, I love you more than anything.
Hallelujah, yes, God. We love you so much because you first loved us. Sing it again. I love you.
I love you, Jesus.
Sounds good. I worship.
I worship and adore.
Just want
to tell you,
Lord, I love you.
Lord, I love you more than anything.
Hallelujah, yes. Sing it again. I love you, Jesus. Come on, sing.
I love you, Jesus.
Yes. I love my worship.
I worship. Just want to tell you,
yeah.
Lord, I love you more than anything.
Come on, let's build it up. Come on, hallelujah.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I love you, Jesus.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. I worship.
I worship. That is why I praise you. I lift you up and I'll magnify your name. That's why my heart is filled.
Hallelujah.
With praise.
That is why my heart is filled.
That's why my praise.
Hallelujah. Thank God for you. You're so worthy. You're so good. Bless you. Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Jesus.
Kings and kingdoms shall all pass away, but there's something about that name. Oh, shall all pass away, but there's something about that day.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
Come on. Amen. Happy Father's Day to all the fathers in the house and to anybody that is a father to anybody out there today. We just, happy Father's Day to you. So it's been a long week, a frustrating week, a hard week, and the devil wasn't done messing with me that I come to church this morning. Everything was fine. 30 minutes before church was supposed to start, everything broke. And it, and some things just got fixed. So, but it's all right. God's business must go on this morning. So give an honor to God for another opportunity to stand in his presence. I am going to read just one verse. Keep your seats. 1 Corinthians chapter 11. We are in verse 7. 1 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 7. For a man indeed ought not to cover his head, for as much as he is the image and glory of God, but the woman is the glory of man. May God add a blessing to the readers and hearers and doers of his holy word. Bow with me for a moment of prayer. Most heaven gracious Father, I come before you right now in the name of Jesus, Father. I come praising you and worshiping you, Lord. I come surrendering to you, O God, and asking you to fill me, O God, that I would decrease 100-fold and you would increase 100-fold, O God. God, I'm the instrument that you've chosen this morning, O God. So have thine way with me, O God, as I step out on faith, O God. I know that your word will go forth and will not return to you void, O Father. And Father, we all declare happy Father's Day to you. And we thank you for allowing us to be your sons and your daughters, O Lord. And allow us to be grafted in into your inheritance, O Lord, and into your kingdom, O God. We thank you, Father, because you have been a wonderful Father. You've been gracious and loving and merciful. You're always there for us when we need you, and we are truly, truly thankful and grateful for who you are in our lives, O Lord. So God, forgive us, forgive me for the sins I've committed by word, thought, or deed, by omission and commission, Father. Father, have your way with this instrument that you've chosen this morning, O Lord. In the name of Jesus, I pray. Amen. Amen. Title of the sermon today is The Glory of God. And that is not a small thing and a small statement that God made to say that man is the glory of God. And so I just want to examine that today, and I want to encourage men to live a righteous and holy life. So we are going to just dive into what God says in his word, and we're just going to explore that topic. So he says here in verse 11 and 1, be ye followers of me, even as I also am of Christ. So now this is Paul speaking, and he is speaking to the Corinthian church, and he's telling them, as I follow Christ, follow me. The most important thing, men, we must do as sons of God, as leaders in our home, as men, period, we must surrender all to our Lord and Savior Christ. We must follow the example that he set as he walked on this earth, and we must follow that path. So we must follow Christ and all of his teachings and take them to heart. And we're not just to listen. We're not just to repeat them, but we are to live the words that Christ spoke. And we are to, our actions are to prove and show that we are born again and that we are the sons of God. Be ye followers of me, even as I also am of Christ. Now I praise you, brethren, that ye remember me in all things and keep the ordinance as I delivered them to you. We have a command, men, to keep the word of God. You need to know what God says about you. You need to know about the role God has put you in and the position that he has placed you in, because he has declared that you are his glory. And if you are God's glory, let me explain you something. So I want you to get the big head. See, just because he calls you his glory doesn't mean necessarily what you think it means. It means you have a responsibility to magnify God. That is why he calls you his glory. Because he has a purpose for you in your life, and it is to magnify him, to show forth his glory through the way you live your life. By you living righteous and holy, you magnify the name of God. You magnify his existence. You prove that he is God when you live by his commandments. You are the glory of God, and it is your duty to magnify the character of God. You should be loving. You should be kind. You should be an encourager, a protector. Those are all the things that you should be when you are a man of God. You should be merciful. You should be a provider. You should be all of those things. And even that, man, and sometimes you don't even realize that you're supposed to be a nurturer too. Sometimes you think that's a woman's role, but it's not just a woman's role. God placed you in the house as the head. You're to teach your young men how to love. And how are they going to know how to love if you don't be a nurturer in the home? If you're afraid to cry in front of them, if you're afraid to hug on them and love on them, if you don't give them the love of a man, somebody else will. You are the glory of God, and you should magnify his attributes and his characteristics throughout your life. He says, but I would have you know that the head of every man is Christ. So you don't need to, you don't need to forget who's your boss. You don't need to forget who's leading you. And his name is Jesus, the Christ, our Lord and Savior. He is the head. He is your leader, and that is who you follow. See, it is a dangerous thing if you're not following anybody. We all should be following something, and you should know where you're going. And if you don't know where you're going, I wouldn't follow you out of a brown paper bag. You wonder why you're having issues in your home. You wonder why your children are disobedient, because you don't have a plan. You don't know where you're going. You're wondering why your wife or your significant other won't listen to you and won't follow you, because you don't have a plan. You don't know where you're going. You're not grounded in the word of God. You're not leading. You're not magnifying God in your life and in your home. Because if you were, submission would be a part of your home life. But you have got to live according to the word of God. But I would have you know that the head of every man is Christ, and the head of the woman is the man, and the head of Christ is God. Christ himself says, I've got a leader and I follow him. I do the bidding of my Father. I've come to do my Father's will. So whose will are you doing? Christ's will or your own will or the will of the devil? Whose will are you executing in your home? How are you magnifying the glory of God in your home? How are you exhibiting and showing your children what a man really is? And you don't get upset when your daughter brings home a man that acts like you, talks like you, walks like you. Because it's your fault if you don't like him. Because how you magnify God before her is the type of man she's going to be attracted to. So if you're magnifying the devil, she's going to bring the devil home. But then you need to go look in the mirror and ask yourself, how did I live before my daughter? Women, don't that apply to you too? When that son bring that woman home and she act like you, talk like you, got an attitude just like you, go look in the mirror. Because if you were not magnifying God, if you were not reverencing the man that God placed in your life, because you're his glory, and you should be magnifying what he's magnifying. So don't get it twisted. He says, and the head of woman is man, and the head of Christ is God. Every man praying, prophesies, and have his head covered, dishonor his head. We are never to dishonor God by the way we live our lives, men. We need to take an inventory of who we are as a child of God. We need to take an inventory of the type of man we desire to be. And we need to reflect on our lives. And if there's anything amiss in our character, our personality, in the way that we're living before God, we need to make a change and we need to repent for the way we've been living and ask God to come anew into our life and order our steps. He says a righteous man can fall seven times, but God will pull him up. God will order your steps if you will surrender him to him and bow down to him. He says, for if the woman be not covered, let her also be, oh, I skipped one, but every woman that prayeth or prophesieth with her head uncovered, dishonor her head. For that is even all one as he, as if she were shaven. For if the woman be not covered, let her also be shorn. But if it be a shame for a woman to be shorn or shaven, let her be covered. Your hair is a covering for you women. But not only that, I'm going to talk about another covering, man, because this ain't about them today. You're the covering of the woman in your house, of the women that live with you. You are their covering. You're their protection. You're their provider. You're everything that God calls you to be for them. If you have been charged with the responsibility to care for them, if you asked her to marry you, if you asked her to be your girlfriend, if she's your significant other, if you have a friend that you call a sister, your aunt, all of them, it's your job to cover them, to look out over them, to watch for them, to make sure that when the devil comes for them, that you can step in the way. Now, that doesn't mean, ladies, you don't have to have your own relationship, because you do. But for the women that are in your life, men, you should be their covering. Means you should be loving them, caring for them. You should not be exploiting them and taking advantage of them. You should be building them up, inspiring them, encouraging them, helping them to be better than they are today. That's your job as a man. So you want to be the glory, but all you're focused on is leading. All you're focused on, do as I say. But you're not focused on the job at hand. Your job is to magnify God in your life. Your job is to magnify God in everyone's life that God places in your life. You have an assignment, and you must take that assignment seriously if you're going to be the glory of God. You must allow His will to be manifested in your life and in the life of others through you. If He's charged them to be with you, if He's given you that assignment, accept it and live up to it and stop ducking your responsibility. Be the man that God called you to be. He says, for a man indeed ought not to cover his head, for as much as he is the image and glory of God, but the woman is the glory of the man. He says, you are the image and glory of God. Let's go to Genesis. Genesis 1, 26 and 27 says this. And God said, let us make man in our image and after our likeness, and let them have dominion over the fish of the sea and over the fowl of the air and over the cattle and over all the earth and over every creeping thing that creepeth upon the earth. So God created man in his own image. In the image of God created he him. Male and female created he them. God gave you dominion over everything. But you can't be like Adam. See, Adam dismissed his responsibility. Instead of him standing on the word of God and saying, this is what God said. Instead of Adam saying, as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. As for me and my house, this is how things are going to be, because this is what the word of God says. And because Adam would not stand up, because Adam dismissed his responsibility because Adam refused to magnify God in his life, him and Eve were kicked out of the garden and they were cursed. Be obedient to God. Don't dismiss the things that God has spoken over your life, the things that God has poured into you, the things that God has told you to do, men. You need to live up to them. You need to embrace that responsibility. And no matter who tries to lead you astray, you stand your ground. Because you not standing your ground is detrimental to those you're supposed to cover. It is detrimental to those that you are to lead if you are the head. Because Adam did not uphold his responsibility, paradise was lost and sin was brought into the world. Know your assignment, know your purpose, and magnify God at all times, for you are his glory. He said you're made after his image and his likeness. That's not a small thing for God, because the Bible, the angel said, who is man that God is so mindful of him? God took the time to mold you to look like him. And not only did he do that, he wanted to spend time with you. He created Adam because he wanted to spend time with Adam. And he did. He sat and talked with Adam. Men, God wants a relationship with you. He wants to sit and talk to you. He wants to shape your life. He wants to lead and guide you, but you've got to sit down next to God and hear him talk. You must sit at his feet and say, Jesus, what is it that you want to tell me? What is it that you want to teach me? How can I magnify you? How can I glorify you? How can I worship and praise you with my life? If you want a better life, man, if you want success in your life, start to magnify God in every area of your life. Isaiah chapter 43, verses 1 through 7. And this is God talking to Israel. But now thus said the Lord that created thee, O Jacob, and he that formed thee, O Israel, fear not. And he's also talking to Jacob. For I have redeemed thee. I have called thee by thy name, thou art mine. When God created Adam and he breathed into his nostril, he became a living soul and he called him Adam. God says he knows you in your womb before you were even formed. He says he knows every hair that is on your head. God intimately knows who you are, men, and he wants you to live up to the things that he's spoken over you. For you have been redeemed, and you were redeemed by the blood of Christ dying on the cross, that shed blood that allowed you to be saved. When thou passest through the waters, I will be with thee, and through the rivers they shall not overflow thee. When thou walkest through the fire, through the fire, thou shalt not be burned, neither shall the flame kindle upon thee. You are the image of God. You are the likeness of God. You are his glory. And when you magnify him, no matter what troubles come your way, no matter what situations come your way, men, if you will stand up and lead and declare that God is the head of your life, if you will declare that you're going to live by God's word, if you would do that, no matter what comes your way, you can face it, and your wife will follow you. The women in your life will follow you because they know you're following God. Nothing can stop a man of God. No weapons formed against you shall prosper. He that is in you is greater than he that is in the world. You are the glory of God. Magnify God in your life. Stand for him and move forward and see what God will do on your behalf. For I am the Lord thy God, the Holy One of Israel, thy Savior. I gave Egypt for thy ransom, Ethiopia and Seba for thee. God said, I gave a lot for you, Israel. I gave a lot for you, Jacob. God is telling us, men, I sent my son to the cross to die for you. He shed his blood for you. You were bought with a price. I gave my only begotten son for you. You need to understand what I've already done for you. And stand up and be the man I called you to be. Since thou was precious in my sight, thou hast been honorable, and I have loved thee. Therefore will I give men for thee and people for thy life. God says, look, I love you, and you're precious to me. There's nothing I won't do for you when you're mine, when you're my son and my daughter. Listen here, man. There's nothing you shouldn't do for your family. There's nothing you shouldn't do for the people that you love in your life. You are their covering. If you want to be a leader means you sacrifice some things. It means you got to be willing to go through some things. If you want to call yourself the head, if you want to be the boss, you got to be willing to pay the price. You got to be willing to put in the work. You've got to do what nobody else is willing to do. He says, fear not, for I am with thee. I will bring thy seed from the east and gather thee from the west. God is with you. Everything he spoke over Abraham's life, he's starting to bring it to pass. And he's just reassuring Jacob, reassuring Israel, I've spoken over your life, and I'm bringing it to pass. God has spoken over your life, man, but you need to know what God says about you, what God says about your life, and then you need to embrace it, and then you need to walk in it. He says, I will say to the north, give up, and to the south, keep not back. Bring my sons from far and my daughters from the ends of the earth. There is nothing that can separate you from the love of God. There is nothing that can prevent God's will being manifested in your life. He says, I have nothing but thoughts of peace towards you. He says, and there is an expected end. He says, I know the plans. I know the plans I have for you. God has a plan for you today, man. But you need to stand up and be a man. Stop being a coward. Stand up. Stand up. I don't care what the world says a man is supposed to be. Your image, your identity is found in the book of Genesis. You're made after his image and after his likeness. There is greatness in you, but you must have a relationship with Christ to unleash that greatness in your life. He says, even everyone that is called by my name, for I have created him for my glory. Everyone called by my name, for I have created him for my glory. You were created for God's glory, not your own glory. Stop seeking glory for yourself. Everything you do should be to glorify God. Stop seeking your own. You serve a King of kings, a Lord of lords, the God of gods, who can bless you beyond your wildest dream. But yet, you're chasing your own glory instead of magnifying him. If you will start magnifying him, he'll give you the power to get wealth. He'll open doors that will never have been opened for you before. When you put him first, you've got to honor God with your life, man. He says, I have formed him. Yea, I have made him. You need to know who made you. God made you. He created you. And just like you want your children to respect you because you think you brought them into this world, but you didn't, God did. Just like you want them to bow down and be obedient to you, but you won't do that for God, the one who created you, the one who can destroy body and soul, the one who molded you and shaped you, the one who spoke over your life, the one who gave you a purpose. He says in 1 Corinthians chapter 10 and verse 33, whether therefore ye eat or drink, or whatsoever ye do, do all to the glory of God. That means, man, you need to sit back and think about all of your actions and what you're doing in your life. Everything you do should be honoring God. You should be a righteous and a holy man. You should be doing what God has called you to do. Stop leaning to your own understanding. St. Matthew chapter 5. verse 16. St. Matthew chapter 5, verse 16. He says, let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify your Father which is in heaven. God says, let the light that is in you so shine. Let the love of God be seen in you. Let Christ be seen in you through the way you magnify God and the way you live your life. But not only that, he said, that men might see your good works. See, Christ said, you are my workmanship, created unto good works. So what are you working? You working something good or you working something bad? The Bible says you reap what you sow. Be not deceived. God will not be mocked. So what are you sowing? What are you building? What kind of workmanship are you? Because Christ says you're his workmanship, created unto good works. So that tells me you can do some good things, man. That tells me that there's some greatness in you, man. But you've got to ask the question, why aren't you living up to it? Why aren't you doing good works? Why is not the greatness of God coming out of you? Well, it's simple. You're not magnifying God in your life. And you need to start. Acts chapter 17. 24 and 25. God made the world and all things therein, seeing that he is Lord of heaven and earth, dwelleth not in temples made with hands, neither is worshipped with men's hands, as though he needed anything, seeing he giveth to all life and breath and all things. God don't need you. There's nothing you can do for God. So don't think you are a prize because he called you the glory of God, because he don't need you. The opposite is true. You need him. You need to be seeking him because he's a rewarder of those who genuinely seek him. You must believe that he is. You must put first things first. He says, seek ye the kingdom of God. And all these things shall, and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you. St. Matthew 6 and 33. But what are you seeking in your life? What are you chasing after? You should be chasing God. Psalms 34. And actually, I'm gonna read 1 through 5. I will bless the Lord at all times. That's your job, men, to bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. You should be continually praising a man because how good he's been to you. Because his mercy is renewed every morning. He got you up this morning. He gave you a job. He put food on your table and clothes on your back. He gave you the activities of your limb. Every day you get up, you should be praising him. You should be blessing the Lord at all times because of how good he's been to you. You should be just blessing him because he called you his glory. He says, my soul shall make her boast in the Lord. The humble shall hear thereof and be glad. Woo. He says, my soul shall make her boast in the Lord. Who is your soul crying out for? Who is your soul acknowledging? Who is your soul magnifying? He says, the humble shall hear thereof and be glad. 3 says, oh, magnify the Lord with me. Let us exalt his name together. Hallelujah. See, we need to be like King David. Didn't mind praising God. Didn't mind dancing and being undignified in front of God. David didn't care who was around. He praised God. He worshiped God because he knew who his Savior was. He knew who his protector was, his deliverer, his provider. He knew who El Shaddai was, Elohim. He knew Jehovah Rapha. He says, I sought the Lord and he heard me and delivered me from all my fears. See, man, there's some things holding you bound because you won't magnify the Lord. There's some things you're afraid of because you won't seek the Lord. He has not given you the spirit of fear, but of a sound mind of love. But there's some things, there's some fear in your life holding you bound. There's some things you can't do and has you afraid to stand up because you won't seek the Lord. But if you would seek him, I sought the Lord and he heard me and delivered me from all my fears. What are you afraid of? What's holding you back from magnifying the Lord? They looked upon him and were lightened, and their faces were not ashamed. Man, if you don't want to be ashamed anymore, seek the Lord. Magnify him. Do what Romans, okay, Holy Spirit, let's go to Romans 12 and 1. That one on the list, so let's go ahead and go there. So I'm going to read it instead of quoting it. It says, I beseech you, therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that ye present your bodies a living sacrifice, holy, acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable service. In the book of Malachi, it says we are to love mercy, that we're to walk with God, that we're to be humble. It says, and be not conformed to this world. Men, why are you trying to be like the world? The world has nothing but destruction and chaos in it. And if you're busy trying to be like the world, that's why there's chaos or destruction in your life and in your home. But he says, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind, that ye may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God. It is your job to represent God well. It is your job to walk in his word, to take up your cross, deny yourself and follow him. You are the glory of God, and your job is to magnify him, to praise him, to worship him. But let me tell you something else, man. You're a teacher. You need to be teaching those under you. You need to be teaching your children, raising them in the way they should go. You also need to be the discipler in your house. Because God says, I chasten those I love. If you love your children, you need to be disciplining them, because discipline is love. You need to be holding them accountable, because God is going to hold you accountable. You don't have to do things the way the world says do things. Do things the way God says do things. God runs everything. Man can't do but what God allows him to do. So who is it that you fear? We need to get it right and do what God has called us to do. 1 Corinthians chapter 7. I'm going to read verse 3, and then we're going to go to 19 through 24. Let the husband render unto the wife due benevolence, and likewise also the wife unto the husband. Due benevolence. Do good things. I'll just make it simple and plain. Husband, it's your job to do good things. Benevolence, goodwill, kindness, and charity. Verse 19, circumcision is nothing and uncircumcision is nothing, but the keeping of the commandments of God. Stop worrying about all these rituals and traditions, all these isms that got us all hung up, that you can't do the will of God. He says what matters is the keeping of the commandments of God. You see, circumcision was a tradition. It was something God commanded them to do, but they got hung up on it. We get hung up on things that have nothing to do with what God would have you to do in your life. And then it's an excuse to keep from moving forward and allowing God's will to be executed in your life. It is an excuse for you not to change. It is an excuse to hold you bound in the situation that you're in. But if you would keep the word of God, he says, my word is the truth. He says, his word will set you free. And if you're free, you're free indeed. He goes on and he says, let every man abide in the same calling wherein he was called. You need to ask God what you were called to be. Ephesians 4 and 1 says, walk worthy of the profession wherein you are called. Well, man, your first profession is being a son of God. You need to walk worthy. Your second profession is being a man of God. You need to walk worthy of that profession. You need to walk worthy in the calling of being the glory of God. He says, thou art thou called being a servant, care not for it, but if thou mayest be made free, use it rather. I'm going to read that again. He says, let every man abide in the same calling wherein he was called. And art thou called being a servant, care not for it, but if thou mayest be made free, use it rather. See, some of you don't like where you are in life. You need to be content with where you are. You need to accept where you are. And you need to use it to your benefit, because there is a benefit for it. Because God says, if you don't care to be a servant, he says, well, okay, that's okay. He says, use it then to set yourself free. Embrace where God has you. Because if you won't accept where God has you and what he's already given you, how can he give you more? If you're not appreciative of where you are now with God in the situation, my time is up. Where you are, how can God take you somewhere else when you despise where you are? He says, for that he is called in the Lord being a servant is the Lord's freeman. Likewise, also that he is called being free is Christ's servant. You have got to embrace what God has spoken of your life and start to walk in it. You must abide in it. You must live in it. He says, ye are bought with a price. Be not ye the servants of men. Brethren, let every man wherein he is called therein abide with God. Stop discounting what God has for you. Embrace being the glory of God. Embrace everything that God has spoken over you. Don't despise where you are. Embrace it and say, God, make my path clear. Show me the plans you have spoken over my life. God, I will magnify you in the life I'm in now. I will magnify you in everything that I do. I will be satisfied with you, God, and I will be unsatisfied with the world. May God richly bless you. The doors of the church is open. You can come by letter. You can come by Christian experience. You can come as a candidate for baptism. You can come and just rededicate your life. The altar is also open. You can come prayer if you need prayer. And for those that don't know, third Sunday normally is our dress down Sunday. Come as you are. But at the end of the day, I don't care how you come, just come. We get so caught up on isms and everything else. The most important thing is the word of God, and that's what we have. So, just come. Amen. Come to the altar. Heart is overjoyed because we have a house full of children. Nothing makes me happier than to have my kids in church.
Yeah.
And as you come, just want to say welcome to Dwindle and Bailey. I pray that this service has been a blessing to you, because your presence has truly been a blessing to us. Amen. Come to the altar, because God said, if there's any among you that is sick, he says, come to the elders and let them anoint you and pray for you. Go ahead and grab somebody's hand where you sit. We do this out of obedience to the word of God, because he says, where two or more touch and agree, he would be in the midst, he would be in the presence. The rest of that scripture says that where two or more touch and agree, they can ask anything in my name, and it will be given unto them. So we put God's word to the test. Because he said, taste and see that I'm not good. He says, I go to and fro throughout the earth on behalf of those that love me, just to prove myself. Most heavenly, gracious Father, I come before you right now in the name of Jesus. I come praising you and worship you, Lord. God, I come asking you, Father, just to have your way with me, oh Lord. I come asking you, Father, as I touch each one on their shoulder today, they have come to the altar, oh God. God, I come asking you to meet them at the point of their needs, oh Lord. God, whatever is weighing heavy on their hearts and on their minds, oh God, I pray that you give it to them, oh Lord. God, I pray that you move the obstacles out of their way and out of their life, oh Lord. God, I pray for strength and healing and understanding, oh Lord. God, I pray for clarification, oh God. I pray, God, that you will give us a spirit of discernment, oh God, in every area of our lives that we need, oh Lord. God, those things that keep us from moving forward and hold us bound, oh Lord, we give them to you right now, oh Lord. God, I pray, oh God, that you just minister to them, oh God. God, and I know you hear their thoughts, oh Lord, and you know what is on their mind, oh Lord. So God, as they lift their prayers to you and their requests to you, oh Lord, I pray that you hear them, oh Lord. God, I pray that you meet them at the point of their needs, oh God. Your word says if we would delight in you, you would give us the desires of our heart, oh Lord. God, I pray that we all will commit our ways to you, oh Lord. And that you will bring our humble request to pass, Lord. So, God, I pray, Father, and I ask you, Lord, that every cry that you hear this morning, oh God, every voice that is being silently lifted up to you, oh God, that you will answer their prayers, oh Lord. God, I know not what they need that is under the sound of my voice, oh God. Those that are watching, Lord, and those that are here, in person, oh Lord. So God, whatever they are seeking today, oh God, I pray that you will give it to them, oh Lord. God, I pray that you will receive them, Lord. God, I pray that you will come anew into their life, oh God. God, I pray that every man under my voice will magnify you in his life, oh Lord. I pray that you will order his steps, oh God. God, this is your house and have thine way in it, oh Lord. God, we come declaring that you are God. We come declaring that Jesus died.
Shout out to them.
I will answer God's call.
I will answer God's call.
I will speak life.
I will speak life.
Yeah.
Last little thing. So we don't take up offering during service. So there is an offering box on the way out if you would like to give, and we will do a better job. I've got a plan to make sure that it's obvious. But we always give on the way out, or you can give online. Amen.
I won't harm you with words from my mouth. I love you. I need you to survive.
His will.
It is His will that every need be supplied. You are important to me. I need you to survive.
You are important.
You are.